Welcome to a short training video designed to introduce you to the different tools and features found in Google Earth. These training videos are designed to assist you in creating and presenting your information to others in a geographic context. This video is part one in a series where you will be examining the different windows, navigation controls, and tools available in Google Earth. Let's first talk about the sidebar windows located on the left side of the screen. The first window is a basic search box that allows you to locate features found on the Earth. These features can be anything from a landmark to a full street address depending on the information you have available. For this tutorial, I'll search for the University of Utah, followed by clicking Enter. This search takes me in for a closer look of the University of Utah and the surrounding area. In addition, information placemarks created by others in the Google Earth community will also populate the area. These placemarks and descriptive dialog boxes are something you will also learn to create in other training videos that can be applied to your projects using basic HTML tags found on the internet. The second window is the Places window, where you'll maintain all the layers of your geospatial project. In this area, you can decide what folders to show by turning them off and on using the checkboxes, adjust the transparency of a layer by highlighting and using the slider bar, as well as control tour functions, which will be covered in another video in this series. The third window contains additional layers provided by Google Earth that you can apply to your geospatial project. There are so many layers to explore in this area, I highly encourage you to explore everything that is available when you have more time. For this tutorial, I'll turn on the 3D buildings layer. As you can see, this layer changed the appearance of the area, adding any three-dimensional buildings that have been created to the layout. The next feature we'll examine are the navigation controls for obtaining different views within Google Earth. The easiest way to move around Google Earth is to simply click and drag across the screen with your mouse. However, there are additional tools that will allow you to obtain more interesting views rather than simply viewing your project from above. The right side of the screen hosts these additional navigation controls to aid you in performing these functions. The first navigation control allows you to rotate the map by holding down the left mouse button and dragging the north arrow around 360 degrees. This function can be performed through a shortcut by holding down the Shift key and using the left or right arrow keys. The directional arrows contained within this ring will allow you to change the angle in which you are viewing. Holding down the Shift key and using the up or down arrows will also perform this function. The second control is similar to the click and drag function of the mouse, but is more useful if you need to maintain precise movements. Using the arrow keys on the keyboard without the Shift key will also perform this function. The third control will adjust the zoom of the map to allow more detailed views of a particular area. For our current example of the University of Utah, I'll go ahead and use these navigation controls to zoom in for a detailed view of the campus. In this view, I can see much more detail of the campus and buildings than possible with the two-dimensional image we began with. I can also rotate and view all sides of buildings by dragging the north arrow around 360 degrees or with the shortcut keys previously mentioned. You'll also notice the pegman contained within the navigation controls. If I hold down my left mouse button, Google Earth will begin populating the city streets with a series of blue lines. If I drag and drop the pegman over one of these lines, Google Earth will take me in for a street level view of the area. This function is helpful for navigation and adds a unique real-world feeling to your project. The final topic I'd like to cover in this tutorial are the functions within the toolbar at the top of the screen. Many of these tools, such as placemarks, paths, polygons, image overlays, recorded tours, and the saving and sharing methods, will all be covered in detail in the next videos. But I'd like to touch on the remaining features available for inclusion in your project. The first two features allow you to change the layout effects within Google Earth. The first is the Historical Imagery tool, which allows you to change the imagery displayed in Google Earth to past aerial images, running back to 1993 in most areas. This gives you the ability to add a little something extra to your project by showing changes to an area over a short period of time. The next tool adjusts the time of day you are viewing in Google Earth by adjusting the angle of sunlight projected upon the Earth's surface. So for instance, if you were studying the University of Utah campus for the addition of a new structure and were interested in showing how the angle of sunlight changes in that area throughout the day, this would be a useful tool for accomplishing such a task. Another interesting function within Google Earth is that your projects are not confined to the Earth. Google Earth offers the ability to expand your projects and research to other worlds, where you can perform the same functions you'll be learning in these training videos on the Moon, Mars, and in the sky. Google Earth has also included a ruler tool with multiple measurement types to make measuring and analyzing an area easier without the need to create additional line or polygon features. Finally, I'd like to introduce you to the Flight Simulator. This tool functions very similarly to the video game and allows you to explore your data in a way represented through the cockpit of an aircraft. This function can be operated using either a keyboard or a joystick, and while the functions must be manually operated, it adds an entertaining feature for viewing geospatial information in your project. This concludes part one of this series. To learn about additional features and functions and how to apply them within Google Earth, please refer to the additional tutorial videos found in this series. Thank you for viewing this podcast and for your interest in Google Earth.